In this module, we're going to talk about equilibrium calculations using what are called ICE tables, which I'll show you in just a moment. But let's just show this with an example, easiest way to do it. So here we go. So at some temperature, the equilibrium constant for this reaction here is 8.3, let's say. We want to calculate at equilibrium what the concentrations of everything present in this container are, carbon monoxide, chlorine, and our product here. So let's say we put 0.93 moles of carbon monoxide and 0.81 moles of chlorine gas into this 2.5 liter container at whatever temperature, K is equal to 8.3. And we want to see, okay, so what's going to happen is at first there is no product, just the reactants, then they're going to start reacting. When they come to equilibrium, there should be some of pretty much everything in there that's in this equation. We want to find out how much there is of each thing, the concentrations. So first of all, we have to calculate the initial concentrations because you're given the moles and the volume. So just moles over liters is the molarity. And so this is a nice table right here. What you do is you write down the equilibrium reaction and you write down how much of whatever is there initially is there. It has to be in concentrations unless you're using Kp, then it has to be in pressures. So this is how much we had initially, carbon monoxide and chlorine and none of the product. C is what the change is. Now in this reaction, the stoichiometric ratios are all 1:1:1. So for every one carbon monoxide we lose one chlorine and gain one of these. So there's just X. Now if let's say for example there was a 2 in front of the chlorine, then it would be minus 2X for that, but it's not. And then this one is at equilibrium. How much do we have of everything? Let's put a little line here. So it's going to be at equilibrium 0.372 molar minus X for carbon monoxide, 0.324 molar minus X for chlorine, and just X for our product. Now that we know the equilibrium concentrations, at least in terms of X, and we know K, we can plug into the equilibrium constant expression and solve for X, just like this. So that's the equilibrium constant expression, plugging in the concentrations in terms of X that we figured out from our ICE table. It looks like this. Now we get a quadratic formula equation on the bottom. So, you know, FOIL, multiply it out, get this. Then we multiply through times, you know, this times 8.3, we get this. So X is equal to 8.3 X squared minus all this stuff. And then when we subtract X from both sides, we get this. And so all you do is you solve the quadratic for X and you get two roots, 0.19 or 0.62. Well, we can eliminate 0.62 using our chemical knowledge. That's nonsense because we know that initially we had only 0.37 moles per liter of carbon monoxide and 0.32 moles per liter of chlorine, and we couldn't lose more than we had to begin with of either one. So we pick one of the two roots, that's our answer. Well, that's what X is. Now to get our answer, all we do is we plug into or substitute back in for X. So at equilibrium, the carbon monoxide concentration will be 0.372 minus X, which is about 0.18 molar. Chlorine, 0.324 minus X, about 0.13 molar. And our product, it's just X, so it's 0.19 molar.